Hi folks, this is Vince and Vinny Jr. with Dad's Gaming Addiction, and today we're going to try out Hythabu, at least that's how I think you pronounce it. This is our first time playing, so keep that in the back of your mind, because we may make mistakes. Now with that said, I did read through these rules, and some of them I didn't like. Some of them didn't make sense, and some of them I didn't like. First off, whenever you take an action on the dark side of the wheel here, basically this is an action wheel, and whenever you take an action on this side, you have to roll a die, and either something good will happen, or something neutral, or something bad will happen. Well, you can actually screw over other players on some of these die rolls here, and I don't like that. I mean, that would just encourage everyone to pick bad stuff and hope to screw over your opponent. So I did away with that, and only the bad actions affect you. I went a step further, just to even things out a bit. The one is receive from each other player one good, or 10 bucks, or one victory point, or six. All other players return one good. In this case, I made 1, 3, and 6 neutral, and 2, 4, and 5 this is actually what happens to you. Return one of your characters, you pay, return one of your transport vehicles. So 2, 3, and 5 are bad for the player, and 1, 3, and 6 are good. So I went ahead and modified things there. On top of that, we were supposed to put out so many goods at the beginning of the game. There's 6 goods here, and or 6 types of goods, I should say. And we were supposed to put out like 10 mead, for example. And in every game that I've played, usually the market is filled up based on how many people are playing the game. In this case, the same number of a good is put out no matter how many people are playing the game, which doesn't make any sense to me. So in a two-player game, you're going to have a lot of resources, and very rarely will the market ever run out. At least that's what I'm foreseeing here. So I went ahead and cut everything in half. So I only did 5 mead. I think there was supposed to be like 6 or 7 cloth here. I only took, 6 or 7. Yeah, I have 6 in my warehouse, or 3 in my warehouse. There's 3 in the market, so I had 6. So basically, we took how many resources we were supposed to have, divided it by 2, because there's only 2 people playing. The maximum in this game is 4, so that's why we came up with half. If you were playing with 3 players, I probably would have cut it into thirds or something like that. So let's go ahead and, 75%. But anyway, let's go ahead and give this a shot. For those of you that are new to the game, basically, we start with an order card and some resources. We're buying resources or acquiring resources from the market based on its current price, and we're trying to fulfill these order cards, which we can acquire from here. We have to transport goods from our warehouse over to our trading post, either by land or by sea. And that's what these cards up here do. There's 3 land and 3 sea. And there's a 20, 30, 40 cost, 20, 30, 40 cost there. And the more expensive they are, the more goods they can carry. And the card actually tells you what color or what type of good it can ship. So with that said, let's give this a shot. And I'll explain rules hopefully as I go. Again, we are house ruling a few things here, so keep that in the back of your mind. There'd normally be more goods here, and normally there'd be more screwage going on. I don't mean that in a sexual way or anything, folks. I meant, you know, via the roll of the die on the dark side. So anyway, family-friendly, guys, family-friendly. So let's go ahead and start with this game. Okay, A through D is on the light side. That's what we started with. And we're on the first month. There's 3 months in a season. Spring, summer, fall, winter, spring, summer, fall, winter. And that's basically the timer for the game. There's 3 months in each season. So after 3 times 8 is 24. So after 24 turns of us placing workers down, you know, that will end that. So let's go ahead and end the game. So let's go ahead and start up. I have the start player card here. So this says start player in the next game turn and game turn change. Basically, whenever this moves over to the next season, I get 10 of this money, which is kind of nice. So I'm going to go ahead and we're on month 1. So I'm going to go ahead and do, say, I think I'll buy a cart and or a boat so I can start shipping resources. So question is, what am I going to get? I have 3 green and 2 orange. So here's a card with a the only card that can transport orange is this one, but there's also a wild one here that's 3. So I may use this card to transport 3 orange, but there's only 2 green on here, which kind of stinks. So I'm going to need a card, say, from over here There's also a 3 neutral on it, or 3 wild. So I'm going to buy both of these cards for 60. That one goes here, and this one goes here. You can only have one card of each type on these spaces. So if I buy another one, I have to get rid of it. And these are a one-time use, though. Once you transport via these cards, they have to go away into a discard pile. So this is worth 60 altogether. So I'm going to do that. There you go. So that's 60. Now it's your turn. You get to put a worker somewhere. You cannot put a worker on the same space that you already have it on. But you can share. We can share spaces of different, different players can share spaces. But you cannot put like the same colored piece on the same spot like that. All right. So you did the same thing. So you're it looks like you're about to buy one.
This one. I'll do this one. And I'll buy this one, and I won't actually buy this one.
Okay.
I have to pay 50 for that.
Okay. So you have to pay 50. So you bought 2 cards, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So put one boat.
I actually bought 2 boats.
All right. Well, put the one boat back and buy land.
I like buying boats, apparently.
Apparently. You like to go sailing. Okay.
I like to go sailing. There you go. You're still 50.
Nice. Okay, cool. Okay, so now that we've placed 2 workers, one for me, one for you, this goes up by 1 month and we rotate the dial. And I actually had to look this up online because this rule book is just worded very strangely. It talks about turns and phases when thematically it's months and seasons. If the rule book had just stuck to saying months and seasons, it wouldn't be so darn complicated. So I think this is how you do it. At the end of every round where we each place one worker, this moves up a month, and then this rotates. All right, so now we're here. Now I get to go. I've got my second worker here. This is month number 2. I can take one order and or sell one good. I don't think I want to do that, though. Let me look at my handy-dandy wheel, which is a player guide here. And it looks like A, B, and C, and H are in the light. So sell, no, hire one character, no. D is here in the dark. Don't think I want to do that. I think I'm going to do this. I'm going to go on B. I'm going to hire one character. I'm going to go ahead and choose the administrator. No warehouse fees. Warehouse and trading post capacity maximum of 15. So this is also safe. And now you get to go.
We'll actually do this on the dark side.
All right. So that means you're going to roll 1 die.
2 die.
You can pay 20.
Nope.
Oh, you have the seer. Oh, okay.
Second event is free charge.
Okay, so normally you would have to roll 1 die when you take an action on this side. Now you can roll a second one for 20, or if you have the seer card, it's free.
This says game turn change. Change the price of one kind of good.
That's player. For the end. Once we're out of workers and we resolve that, that's when we do that. Okay, so you get 2 dice. So go ahead and roll.
So I can affect the die roll.
We'll get there when we get there, but you need a 1, 3, or 6 to say, or 1, 3, or 6 to be safe. A 4 and a 6. Okay, so you're safe. Nothing bad happens to you. 4 and a 6. Good thing you rolled that second die, because otherwise that 4, you pay the current mead price times the number of players. The current price is 5, so you'd have to pay
10.
Yeah, so that's not too bad, I suppose, but that's what you would have to
do it here.
Now you get to take that action. Take 1 order and 1 good, free of charge. So you're going to take 1 good. Okay, so that moves down. And you get to take 1 good from the market, free of charge. Okay, so now you got that. All right, so now that ends the second month. Now we're on the third month, and we're going to rotate the dial again. All right. And now G is in the light. Buy 1 to 3 identical or different goods, price minus 1 level. Well, as the administrator, I can do that. Because I have no warehouse fee, so I don't have to worry about this. My maximum is 10 goods at the end of the game turn, but that rose to 15, so I can buy like mad if I want to. And I'm safe for the moment. Everyone gets a safe marker at the beginning of the game, and whenever you acquire a person for that round, it's safe, or for this year, or for this season, it's safe. Okay, but after that season is over, that comes off, and then people can entice it away from you by paying money. All right, but I think I may do this one. Buy one to three identical or different goods. So what am I going to buy? Well, I don't have any other orders yet. So would it be good of me to do that? Maybe not. Take one order and or sell one good.
No. There's one that allows you to take one.
I could just take one order. And yeah, but if I do it on this side, then I have to...
Roll.
Yeah, I don't want to do that. Well, let me see what orders are in the market right now. Because maybe on the next turn... at the end of the season, these four cards will go away. These will come down, and then we fill.
Yeah, look at this one.
This one fills, okay. So let me look at these top four and see if there's anything I might want. Well...
That one has 8 victory points.
Yeah, see that? But that's a lot of different things.
It's funny.
I think, you know what? I'm going to take this action. Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the G action, and I'm going to buy 3 identical goods. Now, I'm taking the last... So I have to pay -1 of the price level. So normally I pay 20. But I'm paying 16 apiece for each. So 16 30 is 32, plus 16 again is 48. So I pay 50. So I need...
Shouldn't you have...
Well, no, I paid 100. So 100 minus 48 is 52. So I need 52 back. So 52...
Where are your money?
And I take these 3. Now, it goes up... if I take the last good from the market, it goes up by 2 instead of 1. So now it's up to 28. All right, but I get these in my warehouse now. Okay. And now you get to go. Now, consequently, if we ever sell goods here, we can get 2 victory points for that. All right, so what did you just do now? You're transporting goods. Okay, so you did what? You put 2 green... Oh, no, two blue.
That's on the dark side, so that's a roll for dice. I get 2 for
Hold on. 2 blue and 3 of the wild, which is the red, which is what you used. So you use this ship card to transport goods out of your warehouse. Okay, onto your trading post. Okay? All right. 2 and a 1. And you're the 1 is safe, so you're good. All right, so man, you're flirting with danger here. Okay, so that's it.
That's my middle name, Danger. Yeah.
All right, so let's go ahead and...
This is season.
Next season. All right, well, first of all, let's do this in the right order. All order cards are moved 1 space to the right. So move your 2 order cards to the 2 and 3 spot. All right, all character save markers are removed from the character card, so these save markers go away. So now we can steal them away from each other. The special functions of character cards, Seer, Stevedore, Carpenter, and Starting Player are conducted in game order. Okay, so I have 10, I get 10 money. And what's the Seer get to do?
Change the price of one kind of good.
Change the price of one kind of good by plus or minus 1. So you can adjust one of these here up or down by 1. You're going to move it up to 32. Wow. Okay. All right, then. Okay.
No more goods.
Roll both dice and bring new goods into the market. Okay. So where are the dice? Okay. So we're going to roll 2 dice. 3 and a 5. Okay. So the way this works is...
Oh, my God.
For the 3, we get... on the 5, we would get a blue, gray, red, green, yellow. We'd put one cube each of that color. For the 3, 1 red, 1 green, 1 yellow. So I'm going to do 2 yellow, 2 green, 2...
Oh, you're going to do any of your scores.
2 red. Hold on. 1 gray and 1 blue. Okay. So we added new goods. And now, it's not end of the year. End of the year is end of this year. This is a season. All right, back to this. Roll 1 die per kind of good and change the good. Okay, so change the price. Okay, so 1 die. We got a 3 for the mead here, and the mead is 3 is 0. It's currently on this bottom half. So the 3 here is a 0, so nothing moves. For the green, 3, nothing moves. For the red, it's a 5 plus 1. So it goes in twice. The gray is a 3. Nothing happens. 4 is a plus 1. So this goes up to 36.
No, wait, no, it's this side. It'd be minus.
Oh, oh, I see what you're saying. Yeah, you're right. You're right. And then 2 for this is a 0. Okay, so nothing happens. So very little price changing here. All right, except this one down. And what else we got here? Check the capacity of the warehouse and trading post. Maximum of 10 goods each. I have the administrator. Warehouse fees, 2 silver per per good. So you have to put 2 silver for warehouse fees. So it's 2 silver per good. So you, all right, so you need 8. Okay, so you put a 10 back. Is that what you did?
Yeah.
And, okay, so are you getting...
5, 6... 8.
Yeah.
Okay.
And as the administrator, I don't have to pay anything. Take back workers. So let's go ahead and take our workers back.
My guy is like the dark side.
Mm-hmm. And it says the order cards in the lower row are discarded. Now this should go over here, and this goes here. Okay. Those get moved down, and we fill this. 2, 3.
They should have. 4. We're getting all the 4 victory points. Holy. Yeah. This gives you 140 coin.
Yes, yeah, because it's spice is the most expensive. That's the orange one. And then the game turn marker is moved to the next space, which is this.
This one's
you
also
did that
expensive.
Already. And the game phase marker for the action dial is moved to the start, which is this. Okay. Got it. Okay, so now we're on to the second season. Which is summer now. So now we repeat. As the start player, I go first. What am I going to do? Well, I need to get this order done before it falls off my board here. I have these transport cards, but I want to sort of save that until... All right, let's see. Actually, no. We go up by 1, and then we rotate. So now we're up here.
Wait. Okay. Dad, can I do is use this? Could I be any good? So
any
can
good.
Can I do, like, 2 of that color and then do 1 of random
yes.
color?
No. Well, no, it'd be 2 random, 2 of the same color.
Oh.
1 yellow and 1, or 2 green.
Oh, I mean,
this is any color, basically. So it can be 2 red, 2 orange, 2 gray, whatever. Alright. So it's a wild. Think of it as a wild.
Okay,
so, what was I doing?
I think maybe you could split between...
I could transport goods, but do I want to transport right now? Because I might want to save...
For later.
Well, I don't know yet.
I would, actually. Yeah.
Well, no, because I think what I'm going to do, I want more goods. Buy
no,
one
you
with identical... No, take one order and or sell one good. No. Hire... Take one order and one good for each chart. I want D, but I don't want to roll for it. I'm a very safe playing kind of guy. I'm not going to risk it. This A won't do me any good because that'll replace what's there. Take one order.
There might be something better.
I think I'll do this. I'm just going to take... I'm going to take one order. So I'm going to take this one here. And
you should have risked it.
No.
I do. I'm a risk taker.
And this goes down.
I'm a daredevil.
Well, you've got the seer. You can afford to take risk. You've got more risky, you know, you can do that. I can't. I got one
that's
die.
Why
I got a 50-50 chance. And when the
go ahead.
You go now.
First thing I will do.
And again, you can buy directly from here, too. You can sell. You can, or you can use the wheel, whatever. All right, so G is buy 1 to 3 identical or different goods. So you can buy... You're going to buy 3 yellow?
Yep.
All right, at 5. So that goes up to 1. That goes up to 6.
15.
So you pay 15. Okay. Let's keep these separate. Okay. All right, so this rotates. We're on month 2. And I will...
Is there any risk-taking ones that can do?
I could buy stuff. Buy 1, 2, 3. Well,
okay.
I could do that.
I'm going to try to take a risk.
I might buy 3 different goods. I'm going to do 1, and then what else? Let me look at these cards up here and see what one looks good.
I want to buy too many.
Well, I've got a max of 15 as the administrator.
I mean too many of these, because you're not going to complete them all.
You think?
That one's a really good one to have. Just just stuck on these two and just like get like you only need one spice.
Well, I'm gonna do one blue and I have to be a different color, so I'm gonna do an orange and
I do that and buy this. If you get this card, that'd be really good.
Yeah, well, I don't. That's, I need five tools though. That's crazy.
Is that really that?
I'm gonna go with
it's not crazy as this one.
Alright, I'll do
it. I have most of the materials.
So three of different now it has to, its price is minus one level. So it's 12, 24, and 20. That's 44 plus 12 is 66, right?
Yeah.
So I have to pay 66.
I should do is make spice ridiculously expensive.
Alright, I'm almost broke here. Okay, I've got 26 gold left I get these.
How are you broker?
Alright, because I bought a lot of... Look how many goods I have! Alright, your
good
turn.
Good job.
You get to go now.
Funny, I have most of my money.
Alright, so you're shipping... You're using the two and the one yellow... Two wild and one yellow to ship the three yellow over to your trading post, right?
Yep.
Okay.
Now, and then this rotates.
Month three, yep. Yeah. Alright,
I'm going to the dark side.
I will...
I feel like going to the dark side.
I can... deliver, no, transport, the transport. Okay, the transport.
Oh.
That's 1, 2, 3, 4.
I can get a landlord.
Alright, I'm going to transport while I can before it goes into the dark side. I'm going to transport, four of these teal ones.
He's going to the dark side.
And then this has three wild. I'm going to go ahead and do... Alright, this one can do three wild as well. So do I want to do the green or the orange? I think I'm going to do the green... No, orange. Yeah, do the orange. Alright, so this goes away. Alright, and I ship these
My
over
turn.
Here.
Risk taker.
You're a risk taker, it's B. So you hire one character for free. What is that?
It's a fire. When you score, you receive additional one victory and plus 10 gold.
So whenever you
order.
Whenever you do an order, you get extra victory points and money. Okay. So you have to roll two dice then. As the seer, you get to roll one, a second one for free. Yes. And you got a 2 and a 5. So you have to choose one. Return one of your characters, which you wouldn't have gotten the supplier yet. You should have rolled the dice first. But or the storm, return one of your transport vehicles. Lose two victory.
I'll use that.
Lose two victory points if none to return.
I don't have any victory points.
Yeah, we start with 5.
I do that.
All right, so you're gonna go down to 3. Okay. Okay, so you lost some victory points there, but you got your card. All right, so that concludes that. So we're back to let's do this in the right order now. Right order. All order cards are moved to the right. Okay. And all character save markers go away, which we don't have. Again, do it in the right order. The special functions. Okay, start player, I get 10 coin.
I hate.
And you get to change the price on one of these, up or down. Okay, so you increase the price of spice, the most expensive good on the market. And roll both dice.
No one likes spice.
Oh, it says that's one thing I missed. Price adjustment minus one. We should have adjusted the prices down one on the last round, so I'm gonna do that now.
So that one just stays at 25 basically.
Well, and now we do it again. We roll and bring new dice into the market, and then we bring price adjustment minus one. So 1 and a 3, not a whole lot of goods here. So we get 2 yellow.
And 1 red.
1 green and 1 red.
I've got red.
Alright, I've got green. Okay. And then it says price adjustment minus one. So again, this is for this season.
Joe, you have to roll for
these
prices.
Are like dirt cheap. Now we have to roll for each. Yeah. So 2 over here is nothing. 4 is an increase by 1. 4 is an increase by 1. 3 is a 0. Okay, nothing happens. 5 is an increase by 1. And 3 is nothing, so that stays there.
Darn it.
Okay. Alright, so here we are.
I want to make blue very expensive.
We missed stuff. check capacity of the warehouse, blah, blah, blah. Warehouse fees, you have to pay two for yours in the warehouse. Again, I'm the administrator. I don't have to do that.
Did you just take me five?
I took two. No, I took a two.
Oh, yeah, I did spend my...
You spent your five. order cards in the lower row are discarded. Those come down. Four new ones.
It stuck to me.
One, two, three, four. And the game turn marker is moved to the next space, so we're on fall now. And Junior, okay.
$220. Oh, that's a good card to get. I could buy that instead and just...
So, awesome. How much time do we have left? We've got... Okay, this we're only 20 minutes in. Well, I had to stop the camera the one time. So we're really around 30 minutes or so. Anyway, why don't we play one more on camera? Let's see. Okay, so we move it here, rotate. I'm still a star player, so I will...
You can hire another... Wait.
I don't have the money, though. Yeah, as a landlord, I can hire someone, but I think I need to start delivering. Deliver...
Wait, can I just buy him for free, or do I have to deliver up on there?
You have to pay 40 for that.
But if you get the landlord, then you can just pay...
To 20. Yeah. Deliver and score. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. So I'm going to deliver this one here on the 2 space. It's 4 weapons. I've got 4 weapons. So these go back into... Now, do they go back into the market or the supply? There's two different... deliver. Okay, blah, blah. What am I show? Player may not put goods, blah, blah. Okay. Puts the goods back into the general supply, not into the market. Okay, so we're going to put those back here. All right. And I get to score that card. So, and this goes face down to, because this is going to count at the end of the game. So I get 4 victory points. I'm red, right? Yeah.
Yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4. And I get 100 gold for, or 100 money. So I'll take a 100 there.
My turn.
Yep. So you're going to deliver now. That one. Okay, so that's 2 green, two teal. Well, no, 2 blue. The colors are a little bit off here. But yeah, 2 blue, 3 red, and 2 yellow. So that's all of them. So they're going back to the supply there. And...
I get that card.
Okay, so you get 8 victory points.
Nope, 9.
Oh, per your supplier card? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
And I get 110.
And 110. All right, let's go face down over here.
I'm rich.
And he got 100 plus the 10 from this card here.
I'll do this one. I like this one better.
All
right. I'm rich.
All right, so now it's month 2.
I got $200.
All right. Let's see what I'm going to do here. I need to get this out of here.
I need to start getting money. Is there anything I can take?
I've got 3 orange over here, but I need...
I need to get 3 orange.
Okay, so what I'll do is I will hire 1 character, take 1 order, and 1 good free of charge. Okay, I think I will do that. I'll take 1 good free of charge. Which one am I going to want? Well, let me look at... What?
Can I just take all these free orders and just not complete? Do you get penalized for not completing an order?
I don't think so. I'm not sure. I don't know.
You can just borrow these orders just to get free resources, basically.
Well. Alright, so what am I going for, is the question. This one, well...
It would give me a lot of money.
I don't want anything with blue on it, because blue right now is really... I can still buy them from the supply, but I they are very expensive, and the price goes up by 2 each time it happens. So
I just buy a bunch, basically.
Maybe I'll do...
No, you get 2 victory points.
Well, I still need to take a card. I think I'll do... Actually, I'll do this one here.
I'll actually do that. Okay. Because I have, tons of money.
And I get 1 good free of charge, so I'll take a spice. And that goes up by
1. I have a bunch of money, so I can spend... I'll actually do what you're... 3 identical.
So 1 to 3 identical goods.
No, I want to take.
You mean take a good free of charge and take an order? What are you doing?
No.
Put my red one back.
Is that one I can buy? There it is.
All right, first roll the dice, and then we'll do. All right, you got the seer. You've got a 2 and a 5. 2 is return one of your characters. 5 is return one of your transport vehicles. Or lose 2 victory points.
Lose 2 victory points.
All right, so you're back down to 10. Okay, so now you get to buy 1 to 3 identical goods. 3 of those at 24. All right, so you...
If 24 times 3 equal...
Well, it's 40...
72.
Yes. Alright,
so I need...
So this goes up by 2.
I need 28.
28 and change?
Yeah.
10.
10.
5. 7. 8. Alright.
I'm Mr. Spendy over here.
Alright, so this rotates again. We're on month 3. Alright.
I'm paying money for this. I'm paying money for that, but... The thing I'm trying to do right now is, it's working for me.
Do I need a boat at the moment? I think I do, but...
Can I take that action again? And sell one good.
No, you can't take the same action.
Wait, you can sell one good.
Hire one character. Is there a character
I
want? Once per game turn, you can take...
For me.
No, transport any 2 additional goods.
No. Wait, what? What is
it? Stevedore. Stevedore. Yeah. Transport any 2 additional goods. Game turn change. Transport 1 good. Nice. You buy 1 good at 1 lower price level. You sell good.
Imposter. Once per game, you can turn your action to 1 space 4 or 1 space...
Action dial. Some of these are actually...
No, it says action disc.
Yeah, that's this. The action disc wheel. Okay.
So you can rotate it. The screw on the foot is over.
I could.
Basically. Which I don't. You can't do that since I have a shear. So I can.
Well, I need to acquire resources. So I need to.
I can go free.
I could come here and buy stuff, but I really don't want to do that.
Wait, did this go up by 2 since I bought it?
I already did it. I already moved it up by 2. But part of me is like, okay, this is selling. Which one is, buy, see.
It's on the dark side.
Well, actually, this was minus 1 level. So you should have done it at 20, not 24. So you, what did you pay for? 72? 72 minus 60 is 12. So you get 12 back. 5, 5, 1. Because it's a minus 1 price level whenever you do it from there. Alright, I want this. Because that would be nice.
Do it. No one's... You can do it.
Alright, I'll take the chance. See, this is... I'm going to show you exactly why I don't take chances, folks. This is going to be bad. Ready? 3. Nothing happens. Oh, wow. Okay, awesome. Okay, I proved myself wrong. 1 to 3, and I'm going to buy 3 of these at 1 minus
it's
price.
It's 1, 3, and
so
6.
So 60.
You have to roll 1, 3, and 6 for nothing to happen. Mm-hmm. But the other numbers, you get screwed
off. So I get 40 back. I'm going to take a 50 and put back a 10.
You screw yourself.
All right, so that... Okay, now you get to take your turn.
I'll take this order.
Well, actually, this should have moved down, and then this one.
Guess what? I can sell a good. Guess what I'm selling.
Did it say you can?
Yep.
Wait, before you take that action, you have to roll. You can't just do that without taking...
Hey, I have... Well...
Go ahead. Mr. Victory Points over here. 3 and 6.
They both nothing happens.
Nothing happens. Okay, so you're good. So you get this. You got an order and this blue one. Is that what you did?
No, I'm selling it.
Okay, you're selling it.
Yeah.
At 32?
Yeah.
All right, now you also get 2 victory points for that. All right, so you move up by 2.
I just gained the 2 that I lost.
No, does that... What space was that? Okay, so you get 32. Okay, so when this goes down down 1.
Wait, I'll do it to a 10.
Where's your number 2?
1, 5, 5, 5, 1, 1. I'm gonna have to start making chains soon. Alright, so did you get all these freaking fives.
That's fine. Alright, you good?
I'm putting all my fives together.
Alright, so that's it. We did all 3 rounds. So let's do, or 3 months, turns, whatever this damn thing, it's months. I'm going to call it months. Okay, all work cards are moved to the right. So this is on 4. I need to deliver this soon here. Move yours to the right by 1. All your cards.
Yeah, I'm not completing this order.
You need to complete it before it goes, well.
I don't want to.
Okay, all character save markers are removed from.
I have another one.
Okay, I don't have any. Special functions, I get 10.
I'm trying to become money Mr. Maker of the Year.
And what you can change the price of one of these.
By 1.
As the seer. Roll roll both dice and...
Wait.
Dice.
Here, I'll do it. Right.
5 and 4. Okay, so we need 2 yellow. We
two
need
green.
2 green. I got it. 2 red.
I got it.
2 gray. And 1... Aqua, teal, whatever that is.
It's, I'm saying no.
And then we have to,
green.
It's minus,
it's
price adjustment minus 1. 1, 2, 3, 4. Now, I'm guessing that means, now is that minus 1 per edition? Or is that minus 1, that's, all right, let me look that up.
Because my ability lets me get 1, but then it's
hold
just
on, hold
minus
on,
1.
That's not what I meant, hold on. Roll both dice. For each die, add 1 good of each type equal to or lower the number rolled. Afterwards, the price of goods that got 1 or 2 new goods declined by 1 level. Okay, so we only decline it once. But this one did not get a new good, so we leave it as is. Okay.
Actually, I just done this, made it.
Now we roll 1 die for each 5 here, goes up by 1. A 6 here goes
up by
1. 4 here up by 1. 4 up by 1, so why bother changing? 4 up by, oh wait, 4 is minus 1 on that side. And then 5 is
up
by
1.
Okay, so up to 30. Alright.
So we have 1 decrease and all of them increased.
Basically. check capacity. Do you have any goods in your warehouse? So you have to pay 6. Because you've got 2.
I don't think that's a worry for me.
You've got a 5 and a 1. You've got plenty of money over there.
No, look, I got all these 5s, I got all these 1s, I got all these 10s.
I'm administrator, so I don't have to do that. Take back workers.
Good, because look how much money you have. You barely have any right now. So.
Alright, and then order cards are discarded here. Those move down. Draw more.
I hope you...
All right, and then game turn markers moved here. We're in winter now, and we're back
is
here.
Is there any special effect for, like,
and then we move up to 1 and then rotate. Okay.
Are there different effects for seasons?
No, not to my knowledge. Okay, and how much time is on this now? We're on the 30-minute mark. So what I'm going to do is we're going to play the rest of this off-camera, and then I'm going to start this back up again when we're done, and we'll show you who won. So stay tuned. Okay, so this was the end of the game here. As you can see, it's very close. I've got 27, he's got 29. We have some unfinished business that we need to take care of, final scoring and all that. Each player has 3 play loans to the bank. Well, we don't have any loans, so we don't have to worry about that. Each player sells his goods, warehouse, and trading post at 50% of the current price. So starting with me, 50% of 3 is, let's just add.
1.5.
Well, no, let's add them up first. Let's do 12 plus... 45 is 57, right? 12 plus 45 is 57. So 57 divided by 2 is, I'm math.
Something 0.5.
20.
Yeah, it is 28. 28.5.
We'll round it to 28. So I get to sell all of this for 28.
Which is good for you.
10.
4, 8. 4,
5,
8, 12,
and I'll
16,
give back change.
Body.
1, 2, and what was yours now? You had how many yellows?
4, so...
16, that's 8.
Yeah. 1. I still get some profit from what I bought. Mm-hmm. Hey, I got 300 now.
Alright.
I got 300.
Good. Alright, You get per owned character card 2 victory points. Mm-hmm. You have 5 character cards.
Yeah, so I
you get 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. I have 2. I get 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, per 40 silver. All right, so let me make...
I get the 6.
Well, first let's break this up into hundreds so
I did.
It's easy.
I already 50, did. 10, 20, 30,
40, 50.
Yeah, give me 100.
And...
That's it. I got 300. I got 306.
Alright, hold on.
I got that one card I got, the 220.
Alright, so what did you say? How much did you have?
306.
306?
306.
Alright, well the closest the visible number by 4, 4 times 8 is 32, 4 times 7 is 28. So you'd get, so 4... For every 40 that you have, you get
so divide by 40.
1 victory point. So you get
36 divided by
40. Every 40 silver, so 4 times stuff. No, I have this in my head. 40 silver, you have how much?
306.
Well, 7 goes into that instead of 8. So 7 victory points. You get 7 victory points for that. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
You are correct.
Thank you. 100, 200, 300, 350, 360, 370, 380, 390.
What? How? How do you have 390?
Because I have 390. I did some selling at the end of the game. But 390, what goes
390
into...
390 divided by 40.
9 times 4 is 36, so I get... and 10 times 4 is 400, so 9. 9 times 1 is 9, so I get 9 victory points for that.
You're 1, correct.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I can math, people, ladies
You're
and gentlemen.
You're correct. You need a calculator.
9.75. All right. All right. Per 2 goods on order cards, which I don't have any. Per unused transport on a player's mat. Do you have any unused transport? You get
one victory.
You have one, so you get 1 victory point.
No.
Oh, wait, that's me. You get one. Most orders filled. I get 6 victory points. So I got 1, 2, 3, 4. How many do you have?
3.
Well, I get 6 and you get 4. So 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And I think you beat me. And I don't think there's any other endgame scoring.
I think I could beat you in victory points earned for these, because all of them are 8s.
Well...
Look at mine. They're all 8s.
so you have a 8, 4, 6, 4. Like, all of mine. Well...
Hello.
Well, in orders, I got 12, 18, and 20. I got 22 total.
24.
Okay, so we almost... I mean, like, you beat me there. But I think what got... me were the characters, like you got so many characters.
I just kept buying them.
You just kept getting characters.
Yeah, I was gonna do that, just keep getting the characters
mm-hmm.
every round because I have one left over. Get the characters to sell them in the end to get more victory points.
Yeah.
And that really got me points.
So there you go, ladies and gentlemen. Hi, Thabu. Again, this is our first time playing, so I don't know if we did this completely right, but interesting game. Confusing rulebook slightly, and I think the rules need adjusted. My advice to anyone playing this, if you have 2 players, have the market during setup. Don't use the full amount used in the rulebook. 3 players do 75% of the market, not 100%. And then also, take out if you're not into screwage, take out... excuse me. Well, my voice just went out. Take out the 1 and the 6 and turn it into a neutral so that 1, 3, and 6 are nothing happens, and then 2, 4, and 5, something happens bad for you. So there's a 50-50 chance that something bad will happen. If you want to sweeten the pot, it's your game, so do what you want, really. But that's what we did, and it seemed to work
for
us.
Yeah, the one screwed me over, I was trying to get a transport going, And guess what happened?
He rolled two fives. He rolled two fives, and the five basically made him lose the transport. He was trying to use the transport the goods in the first place. So, yeah. He took the transport action, so he couldn't take the action because the five had screwed him. But anyway, hi, Thabu. So, if you guys want to see more gameplay, let us know if you haven't already subscribed to my YouTube channel. And check out my official website, www.dadsgamingaddiction.com. This is Vincent Vinny Jr. Thanks for watching, and we'll catch you next time.